Stop recording from now on. This is the music. Okay, we know it's good music, but please give me some time. I need to introduce the music. Introduce the song. Introduce the class. All right, here we are again. With the ninth grade B on a Thursday the 13th. Luckily, it's not Friday. In today's class, we are going to work with the topic, what have you done? So we're going to focus on language today. Not on vocabulary, not on skills, mainly language. And today, my recommendations are a good variety of music, I think. I've got, for example, a lot of rock music and, well, some old, all of them are old. Master of Puppets by Metallica is an old song by Metallica. If you want to bang your head, this is a song. Eruption by Van Halen. Van Halen, he passed away last year, but he's a guitar rock legend with a beautiful song, Eruption. What a classic. Another classic is Hellbells by AC/DC. A genius piece of music from the classic rock genre. This is more 80s, yeah, more 80s, classic 80s. The song is called Run by A Flock of Seagulls. And I run, I feel so far away. And then we have Stars by Simply Red. What a classic band, awesome British band, I think. Yeah. And finally, I can't finish this list without a tremendous band called Depeche Mode. And the song is called Precious. What a beautiful lyric. Did you know any of these bands or songs? Did you know any of them?
What?
Did you know any of them? Did you know any of them? Did you know any of them? Oh, someone's calling. Okay, I'm back. Sorry, the telephone. Video cangrejo siendo barra. No, a little bit. Ah, Carolina. Did you know any of these songs? ¿Conocían alguna de estas? Did you know? Do you know any of these songs? Do we have any rock and roll fans here? Some rock fans? People who listen to rock? I mean, what the hell? You're writing to me on Russian. Do we have any rock and roll fans here? No rock and roll fans. What do you guys listen to? What kind of music? Is it only just pop music or? Okay, this is very strange. No one is speaking and Camilo Yanez is writing to me on Russian. So it's kind of weird. Ah, thank you, Luciano. Finally, a person that can, finally something, someone that is in the class. Luciano Valencia, you're a fan of rock and roll. That's good, man, that's good. Yeah, I'm gonna put it at the end. Okay, Camilo, yeah, it was in Russian. All right, we have some words for today. We have to book a hotel. So if you're going to book, okay, before you travel to a country for vacations, you need to book the hotel, okay? Book a room. So what do you think a book is, to book something? If you want to go to Canada, you need to book a flight. If you want to go to Japan, you need to book a flight. So what's the book, to book, like an action? Anyone? Let's go. Anyone? Participation? Let's go. Quickly. Buscar. Ooh. Very close, Sofia. Very close. I think it's more concrete, okay? Because you can find out, okay? You can find out information, but this is more concrete. When you book the hotel, it's ready, set. We're going, stay there at the hotel. Vacations. Have a nice time. It's more concrete, okay? Okay. So, I think when you are looking or when you're searching is before booking. You search. Yes, Emilia. Good. Perfect. Reservar. Okay. So if you book something, you're making a reservation to book. So book, we know, is libro, like a noun, right? But when we use book like a verb, it's very different. Okay. Book as a verb is reservar. The luggage. When you are in an airplane, okay, Luciano. Good. Bon Scott.
Porque la canta Brian Johnson.
Yeah.
Y no la canta Bon Scott.
No la canta el mismísimo legendario. That's true. Luggage. When you are in an airport, okay, you get off the plane, you walk a lot, okay, in the airport, and then you pick up your luggage. You pick up your luggage. Yes. Very nice, Sofia and Leonor. Equipaje. Luggage in general, right? So luggage can be a bag, it can be a handbag, it can be a backpack, it can be a purse, it can be your pet, for example. Luggage in general, okay? And also, talking about the same thing, before you travel to a place, whatever place you want to go, you need to pack your things. So what's the action when you pack things? When you need to pack things for a trip. For example, if I go to England in January, I need to pack a good jacket. Okay, a hat maybe, some nice boots as well. A scarf. Come on, people, let's go. Make it work, let's go. All right. Sofia, any idea when you're going to pack your clothes, you pack your things for the trip? Okay, thank you. Yes, empacar. Wow, people, you're very slow today. Me don't like it. Me don't like it. Okay, que estamos. Yeah. No, voy a avanzar rápido, ¿ya? Porque no me parece que estén en otra. Let's go. Okay, so a bit of information on your Google Classroom. Okay, this is the ninth grade C. Okay, yesterday I had a conversation with Master Luciano. Thank you, Luciano. You're very kind. And in the conversation, we talked about the book. Here you can find the book pages. Is a unit in the student book and the workbook are complete. Also, here you have the class videos, and I forgot to post something else. Give me 1 second. God damn it. I forgot to post something else. PDF editor software. This is a software that is going to be very useful. Okay, you're going to use this today. Okay, it's a software that you have to download to your PC, and you can edit PDF. Like in, I'm going to give you an example in a minute. All right, so we have the classes, we have the software, and we have also the book in PDF for you guys to work at that. All right, let's go quickly. We're gonna move quickly because I need participation. I need, okay, answers. So class number 3 is called What Have You Done? So I'm gonna ask some questions to people and their names. So please be available. And I want you to answer the questions with the following thing. I have here different actions. Which of the following actions have you done recently? So you have two possible answers. Yes, I have, or no, I haven't. And also I'm gonna ask you some detailed questions. Okay, yes, I have, no, I haven't. If you have done it, yes, I have. And if you haven't done it, no, I haven't. This is positive. And this is negative. Okay, let's go. We're going to start with Luciano Valencia, the good master. Yes, master, it's language. I don't like to call it grammar itself. I like to call it language. Because we don't pay much attention to the rules. We kind of use it in the context. But yeah, Luciano, let's go. Help me. Let's start with number one. So which of these things have you done recently? Luciano, have you read a book recently? Have you read a book recently?
No entiendo la última parte que me quiere decir. ¿Me lo puede decir en español?
Have you read a book recently? Recently, like this week or last week. Okay, have you read the book recently? Oh, thank you, Leonor. Luciano? Oh, yeah, okay, what book? Okay, what book did you read? What book did you read, Luciano? What's the book that you read? No. Okay, well, that's that. Yes or no? Emilia, okay. So, okay, Emilia, you have read Como Agua para el Chocolate recently. Okay, I have read this book as well recently. Okay, let's continue with the next one. Let's continue with I need people to speak, okay? That's better. Belen Segovia, have you eaten pizza recently? Yes, I have. No, I haven't. Can you use the microphones, please, if you can? Belen? Okay, no, Belen. Emilio Silva, have you eaten pizza recently?
Yes, I have.
Ah, good. What kind of pizza? What ingredients?
Pepperoni. Ooh, tomato.
Delicious.
Cheese. Mm-hmm. Ay, no sé cómo se llama el resto.
Which ones? In Spanish.
Pimentón.
Ah, pepper. Pepper.
Pepper.
Pepper, yeah.
Creo que eso, no me acuerdo.
Okay, so pepper, olives. Pepperoni, tomato, or tomatoes. Wow, I like that combination. Pepperoni is good. It's good. I like the flavor. Thank you, Emilia. You're very nice. Let's continue with another person. Leonor, have you played a multiplayer game recently?
No, I haven't.
No, you haven't. Okay, have you played any games recently?
In this month, no.
Okay, this month, no. Okay, do you usually play games?
After.
Uh-huh, okay. Okay, I get it. Mm-hmm. So no games this week. So have you been very busy? Ocupada? Busy? I think you've been very busy. Thank you, Miss. You're very kind. Good voice, good pronunciation. Hey, let's continue with someone else. Let's go. Okay, we're gonna call now Milenka. Milenka, you here? Milenka, have you cooked anything recently? Okay, she's not here. Okay, let's continue with another person. Sofia Hermosilla, are you here? Have you cooked anything recently? Yes, you have. Okay, what did you cook? Tell us. Well, in Spanish, no worries. I can help you. I don't know. Ah, okay, so tart. They call it tart. Okay, tart. So what ingredients, for example, could be an onion tart. It could be strawberry tart. Kuchen. Yeah, kuchen is tart. Strawberry tart. Wow, that's elaborated. That's good. Good. Awesome. Awesome. Thank you, Sophia. You're good. Okay, let's continue with another person. Okay, Tomás Furet, have you ridden the bike recently?
¿Voy a repetirlo?
Have you ridden a bike recently?
No.
No? Have you got a bike? Have you got a bike? Tomás Furet, have you got a bike? Okay, Tomás Furet is out. Let's call another person. Catalina Vidal, have you ridden a bike recently? Catalina Vidal, have you ridden a bike recently? No, Catalina Vidal. Ignacio Vivado, have you ridden a bike recently? I'm not, or I haven't. No, I haven't. Okay, no, I haven't. Simple, que lo otro no sé. Okay, thank you. Let's continue with another person. Franco Villarroel, what about you? Have you watched a good film or series recently?
A good film or series?
Recently, yes. Have you seen any?
I didn't think so, to be honest.
Okay, don't think so.
Oh, one, I think.
Okay.
One, I remember a movie. It's Monster and Love, I think. It's called.
Monster and Love. Mm-hmm. Okay, so that's
something like that. I think, yeah, I like it, to be honest.
To be honest, you like it. Good. So you have watched a film recently. That's good, man. Good.
Yeah, I think.
Thanks. Thanks, Mr. Franco. Let's continue with Daniel Gonzalez. The Punisher series is really good, man. It's really good. Let's continue with my next friend, Daniel. Daniel, have you gone to the beach recently?
No, I haven't.
Oh, you haven't? Oh, man. Would you like to go to the beach?
Not really.
Not really. Are you a beach person?
No.
Not really. Okay, I understand. Thank you. Thank you, Master, for your honesty. Let's continue with the next question. Let's ask Mr. Cristóbal Velázquez. Cristóbal Velázquez, have you done exercise recently? Okay, let's ask Florencia, have you done exercise recently? Florencia? Okay. Florencia is not here as well. Emilia Silva, have you done exercise recently? Oh, Leonor is participating a lot. Good. Emilia Silva?
¿Qué dijo?
Have you done exercise recently?
No, he hecho ejercicio recientemente.
Yep.
No.
Yes, I have, or no, I haven't.
No, I haven't.
Uh-huh. No, you haven't. But what about physical education?
No, I haven't.
Oh, no, you haven't. Oh, okay. Thank you, Milena Silva. Good, thank you. Let's continue with Miss Leonor. Miss Leonor, have you listened to a new song recently? A new song. Yeah, Leonor, have you listened to a new song that you liked? Like, oh, this song is good.
No, I haven't.
Oh, really? Only the old songs. Only the old songs. Okay, good. Thanks. Thanks, Leonor. Let's continue with another person then. Let me ask Belen, Segovia. Have you hanged out with friends recently? Have you hung out with a friend recently? Like, have you seen? Yes, you have. Good. That's nice. When? Was it last week? Yesterday? 2 days ago? 3 days ago? When was that, Belen?
Last week.
Last week. That's perfect. Thank you. Thank you. That's recent. And finally, let's ask Mr. Camilo Yáñez. Have you gone shopping, Master?
No, I haven't.
No, you haven't. Oh, well, that's kind of good, I think. But let's see. Itira Alday, what about you? Have you gone shopping recently? Well, the supermarket counts as well as shopping.
No, I haven't.
No, you haven't. Stay home.
Sí.
Right.
No sé si internet cuenta, pero no. No he ido.
I think going shopping. But okay, change of question. This is for you, Miss. This one. Have you received anything online recently? Have you received an online purchase? Miss? I think it was this. You see that? Not right.
Como?
Have you received anything online recently?
Mm-hmm.
Ah, cool. Okay, where? Where from? Was it from? From what? AliExpress, Wish, Amazon? Mercado Libre.
AliExpress.
AliExpress. Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. So you have received.
No, AliExpress. No, Mercado Libre era eso.
Mercado Libre. Okay. Yes. Yeah. AliExpress is a courier company. Good, perfect. And Mr. Morales, Ignacio, have you gone shopping recently? Okay, no one. Okay, it seems like you guys haven't gone shopping, which is good. Okay, I wanted to focus on something specific, okay? Can you tell me what's going on with these actions? What about the verbs? What's going on with the verbs? Okay, what's going on with the verbs? What can you see about the verbs?
No sé decirlo, pero están en pasado.
They are in past. Lucas, can you say they are in past?
They are in past.
Okay, yeah, perfect. They are in the past. That's true. That's true. They are in the past. Look at that. Okay. Thank you, Leonor, as well. And look at this one. Look at what I'm going to do now. Okay, sorry. Wrong color. Okay, look at what I'm going to do now. Oh, Sofia, that's very intelligent. Okay, look at this. What I'm doing now. Wow, 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 you guys intelligent. Okay, let's see. Okay, here. And that's it. Okay, Luciano Valencia says, in general rule, we add ed to verbs regular, to the regular verbs in English to become in past. Sofia and Luciano, you nailed it. So, okay, now, this is more specific questions. Why some of these verbs are in blue and the others are in red? I mean, kind of blue. Porque no tiene ley. Okay. No tiene ley. Good. Yeah, simple as that. They don't have ED. How do you call the verbs with ED? How do you call the verbs with ED? I think Luciano, you can say it. Luciano? What's the name of the verbs with ED? Regular verbs. Okay. So that makes the verbs in blue. What's the name of the verbs in blue? Irregular. Yeah, logic. Very nice. So we have here different verbs. Irregulars. Aquí lo puso Leonor. Irregular. Irregular verbs. Okay, so the blue ones are the irregular verbs and the red ones are the regular verbs. Okay. And as you probably know, to do this, we need a list. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to open this a bit and I'm going to move here. Okay, yes, good. Here I have a collection of irregular verbs. Hooray! Okay. These are called the irregular verbs. That's something basic that everyone should know by now. Now, the thing is that if you see here, I need to put the verbs in the past. Okay, good. So you guys are going to help me to put the verbs in the past. For example, here. Okay, let me zoom it up a bit. I want 100%. Okay, help me here. What would you put here is if I have just breakfast? What's the past of have, people?
Have.
Okay. Okay. I'm gonna put that. What about this one? My brother hasn't played GTA 5. What's the past here?
Lion.
Okay, played. Good. Okay. Let me wait a second. Played. Wait aquí. I have explained something quite useful. Here, explain in the past. Explained, thank you. Explained, perfect. And here I have go. My mom has go to the beach for a walk.
Goes.
Yeah. Thank you, Ellen. And my cat hasn't sterilized.
Get. Oh, no.
Now the verb is be. What is the past of be? Gala.
Was.
Okay. All right. Okay, so we have here a bit of a confusion because what we can see here is that we have to use the verbs in the past. That's correct. Okay. And we have different verbs. For example, have, it's an irregular verb. See is an irregular verb. Go is an irregular verb. And be is an irregular verb. That means if I go to the list, I can find them here. So for example, let's go to the first one. The first one is have. So if I go here, have. Okay, there we go. Have is here, right? Now, in this unit, Luciano, we are going to use this, okay? The column number 3. In this case, the blue column. So we have
have. Entonces le quitamos la E, ¿no?
Yes, because this was incorrect. Incorrect. Actually, no puede llevar D porque no es regular. Yeah? It's an irregular verb. Then I have the verb see. I know. I go to the list. I go to the list now. And I find the verb see, and I think it's here. Here, okay. So, in the other class, people told me, teacher, the past of see is saw. Yeah, perfect. It's past simple, yeah. But in this unit, we are going to work with seen, okay? See, saw, seen. In this have, had, the end. We are going to use this one, okay? So that would be the correct one. So that's why we have seen. Why? Ah, that's a good question. Okay, we are working now with a different type of idea, okay? Look at this one. Look at the difference. Listen to the difference. Okay, in the other class, they say so, and I said, oh, okay, but it's not correct because if you read this, I have never saw Avengers game. Nunca he vi Avengers game. On the contrary, if I write scene, nunca he visto Avengers Endgame. Okay, so they are different past. Ah, so cierra. Yeah, also. Also. So we have see, which is ver, saw, which is vi, or viste, or vieron, or whatever. But seen is visto, okay? It's a different, yes, good. It's a different type of verb. And we are going to use these ones. They are called the participle verbs. Okay, this one, participle verb. Okay, we're gonna give it more explanation now, okay? So here, this is incorrect because the verb go, if I go to the list and I find the verb go, okay, what is the verb of go, the participle? People? Gone, thank you. Okay, so here is gone. The one that I want is gone, okay? That would be the correct form. So it's not goes, it's gone. Okay, my mom has gone, se ha ido. It's not went, mi madre se ha fue, no. Se ha ido, gone. We need another verb. And this is the correct one. This in English obviously has a name, and we are going to check a video and you will be clearer. For example, be is another verb that is irregular. And if you go here, thank you, Sofita. If you go here, we can see that the verb is right there. It's the verb been, right? Been. Been is the correct verb, estado, yeah? No fue, estado, o no era, estado. My cat hasn't been sterilized. No ha sido esterilizado. Okay, so what's this? It's very simple. Okay, Leonardo, that's a good question. That's a super good question. I'm gonna give it to you in a minute. Okay, so when we are working now, we are going to be using, Luciano, 1 second. We're going to be using the past participle, okay? With the verb, sorry. We are going to be using the past participle, okay? This one's the third column of the verbs. Luciano, question.
No, teacher, solamente le iba a decir que I got confused with the irregulars y no era eso nomás, pero eso.
Okay, good, confused with the irregulars. So you mentioned that we have verbs, okay? And also you mentioned that verbs have two possibilities. They can be two possibilities, okay? They can be regulars. And they can be regulars. Let's go to regular. Okay. So here you said that the regular verbs in the past, they have ed. But the irregular verbs, they are in a list. Okay. In the list. And this is the list. For example, let me go. for example, if I want to find the verb play, play, teacher me dijo, busca play. You can play, blah, 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 blah. Beep, beep, beep. Gala, what's going on? Play, no play, no stop. It's not here because play is a regular verb. No lo va a encontrar nunca porque es un verbo regular. Okay, so here in this list, only the irregulars. La cosa es buscarlo and use the participle column. Now, Sofia asked me a very important question. Leonor asked me a very important question. When do I use it? ¿Cómo sé cuándo usarlo? It's very, very simple. Let me put here this one. ¿Cómo decir, cómo saber cambiar entre decir, I went to the cinema and I have gone to the cinema? Okay, I can say, I'm not writing. Okay, I went to the cinema last night versus I've recently gone to the cinema. Just gone to the cinema. Okay. We are here. Okay, these are the two examples. So that's a very good question, Miss Leonor. Here, the difference is very simple. Wait. Ahí está, ahí lo encontré. Encontrarla, anotar. Okay. Okay, here we have went. It's a past simple. Something that you studied in octavo básico, probably séptimo, whatever, with irregular verbs. And explain something that finished. Okay, I went to the cinema last night. Finished. Action finished. Okay, I went yesterday, watched the movie, whatever, finished. But this one explains something different. I've just gone to the cinema. It means that I recently went there to the cinema. Maybe yesterday, maybe in the morning, maybe at 2 p.m. You don't know because it's not important. And I'm telling you because I'm telling you my experience, okay? So when you are telling people about things that you did in the past, not exactly when, but because they are important and they impact your experience, you're gonna be using this one, okay? This one. Oh, yellow, sorry. This one, okay? I've gone to Zuma. You can say, for example, I've read a book. He leído un libro. I did it recently. Okay? It's my experience. So when we speak about experience, we're going to be using this. Don't get confused. We're going to watch a video now. Yes, Luciano. I've just gone to the cinema. He ido al cine. Fui recién. Fui hace poco. Okay? It's usually an action that it happened recently. But look. Let's have a look at the following video. Okay, I'm going to show you a video. It's going to explain a bit this. Si ustedes son fanáticos de la gramática y todo eso, bueno, aquí va a salir un nombre de cómo se llama esto. Yo no soy tan fanático porque me importa más cómo se ocupa, más que cómo se llama. Pero aquí van a ver como el detalle. No sé qué es loading. I'm going to stop that too. What's going on? Let's reload. Ah, thank you. What a nice person. Okay, give me one sec. I'm entering. Okay, good. So we're gonna watch this video. Just give me less than a minute. Yeah. They have everything programmed. It needs to be programmed because we are professionals. Okay, come on, work. Thank you. Ready? Okay, here we go. Let's go to the video. Okay, in the video, a man will explain this a bit more, okay? And you will say, ah, okay, this is simple. That's good. We're going to put some English subtitles with the video. Whoop. English subtitles, ready? Let's go. Do we have volume? Yes, we have volume. Perfect. Let's go. Here we go.
ESL Library. Present perfect.
Okay, is everything okay? Can you see well? Can you hear well?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, let's go. Okay, that's the name of the thing that we are using, present perfect.
What are verb tenses? Verb tenses show if an action takes place in the past, present, or future. The present perfect is a verb tense. We use the present perfect tense for two reasons. The present perfect can show a finished past action. It doesn't show when this action took place. For example, I have been to Australia. The present perfect can also show a continuing action. Mm-hmm. It shows an action that started in the past and continues to the present. This action might continue into the future too. For example, I have lived in Toronto for 2 years.
Okay, I can say, for example, I have been a teacher, okay, for 11 years, for example, and continues to the future. So we don't know exactly until when. And in the use number one, we use it for experiences. For example, I can say, I have eaten pineapple pizza in my life. It's not important when, but is in my life. I've done it. I have been to Australia, yes, in the past, but is it relevant when? So we're talking about experience.
The present perfect is formed with the auxiliary verb have and the past participle form of the main verb. Have changes forms depending on the subject. I have finished my homework. She has worked at this office for 12 years. My friends have seen that movie. With regular verbs, we use the verb plus ed to form the past participle.
Lived, wanted, listened.
For example, the past participle of the verb walk is walked.
Walked.
With irregular verbs, the past participle changes into a different form. We do not use ed. For example, the past participle of the verb eat is eaten.
Eaten, the third column.
Here are some examples of irregular verbs in their base form, past form, and past participle form.
Participle.
Listen and repeat. Be.
Be.
Was or were.
Was or were.
Been.
Been.
Do. Did.
Did.
Done.
And this is the one that we use. Done.
Drink. Drank, drunk. Eat,
ate,
eaten.
Eaten, okay, so it continues like that. It shows more examples.
Sleep.
Check that on the list. Then we come here.
He has eaten breakfast.
Okay, he has eaten breakfast. The verb in the past participle and also the auxiliary.
We have had a dog for 8 years.
We've had a dog for 8 years. Hemos tenido un perro, todavía vive.
My best friend has moved to another city.
Se ha cambiado. Uh-huh.
Thanks for watching.
Okay, so let's put this into action. So I have here some examples before you go to the classwork. So we have to complete with the with the correct thing. So we have Mount Everest. Let's start with the auxiliary. Is it has or is it have? She.
He has.
Has. Okay, remember, yeah. She and he and it, they use has. She, he, it are super connected with the S, always. Now, the verb is hike. Spoiler, the verb hike is regular. What do we do? What do we do? Ah, sorry, the chat. Hiked. Perfect. Hiked. Good. Okay, it's regular. Por lo tanto, si yo, Carolina, lo voy a buscar acá, hike, no estaba. Quiere decir que es regular. Yeah. Si no está en la lista, es regular. Por lo tanto, es de. Yes, escalar. Es to climb. It's not like that steep, but it's to climb. All right. What about this one? Jill on vacation. So Jill has or Jill have? Jill, I think it's she.
Has.
Jill has. And the verb go is an irregular verb.
Went.
Ooh. Okay, what about now? Have a look.
Gone.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah, don't worry, it's normal. This is horrible. Okay, this is terrible. Nunca lo van a aprender, ¿ya? Lo vamos a aprender de otra forma y les voy a contar cómo. Okay, so gone. Okay, I need that verb. Se ha ido. Ah, where is the thing? She has gone on vacation. Se ha ido vacaciones. Se ha ido, quiere decir recientemente. Okay, what about this one? They through France. France. They have or they has?
Have.
They have. They have. And cycle is a regular verb. Spoiler.
Cycle? Oh, no.
Yes, yeah. Cycled. That's it. Si lo busco la lista, no va a estar. What about this one? Mike has or Mike have? Is he?
Has.
Perfect. Have. And let's go to the verb. The verb is fly.
Flown. Una cosa así.
Flown. Flown. Yeah, that's correct. Flown. Mike has flown. Ha volado. Okay. No voló. Ha volado de Angeles to New York. Okay. You sail a boat before, haven't you? Okay, you have or has?
Have.
Sailed, spoiler, is a regular verb. You've sailed.
Sailed.
Yeah, sailed. Perfect. Then we have travel. My friends. Is it have or has? Have or has?
Porque está hablando del amigo, ¿no?
My friends. They have. Good. Travel is a regular verb again. Regular verb. Travel. That's correct. Travel. Ojo que travel en inglés británico es con doble L, inglés americano es con una L. ¿Ya? Para que no se sorprenda. No surprises. And let's finish this one. We travel across the country. Okay, we have or we had this? Or we have?
We have.
We have and drive. Spoiler is an irregular verb.
Driven.
Yeah. We have driven. Hemos manejado. A lo largo, o sea, a través del país. Hemos manejado.
¿Profe?
Ya, yeah, master.
Perdón que lo interrumpa, yeah. Pero ¿qué había dicho que de la anterior? Traveler, no. ¿Cómo era? Que en americano no sé tanto y...
Ah, yes. Here, traveled with double L is in British English. And traveled with one L is American English.
Ah, ya entendí. Gracias.
Okay, so have driven. Okay, we have the idea. Actually, it's not very difficult to understand. So what you're going to do is very simple. Okay, Let's go to the classwork. A ver si alcanzamos a trabajar. Yo creo que sí. Okay, this is the 9th grade C. So we are going to publish now. Okay, you guys gonna work in groups between one person to three people. Okay? One person to three people. And what you're gonna do is very simple. Okay, let me publish this. This is 1 point. And traveler stay, unit number 2, traveler stay, yeah, good. Okay, I'm gonna give you the piece of homework in a minute. And okay. All right, first things first, the homework, okay? So here in Google Classroom now you have the classwork. Bueno, un trabajo en clase en realidad. The instructions are very simple. I'm gonna open this up. These are the instructions. So think about now, who would you work, who are you gonna work with? Okay, the idea is in groups of three, it could be two people, it could be alone, but the maximum is three people, okay? Yeah, sure, yeah. Okay, you get together and you're gonna do the activity 4 and 5 from the page 112 with the book and with the PDF editor, okay? Then one person through Google Classroom sends the PDF modified with the answers. So now here I mentioned in the classroom, you have the book. So you need to find the page 100. Sí, también está. The page 112 está acá, en esta cosita. Y aquí está la fotito de lo que hay que hacer acá. Aquí, Sofía. Okay. This is the PowerPoint. Aquí está la lista de verbos. Okay. And algo muy importante es que tienen que descargar el programa. ¿Ya? Alguno de los su compañeros debe tener este programa. Se ocupa así, muy fácil. Mira. Aquí estoy. Y yo ya lo abrí, está instalado porque yo lo ocupo mucho. Entonces, abrí el PDF que descargué y luego puedo escribir en él, ¿no? Por ejemplo, aquí yo sé que has hiked y aquí me da para escribir. Entonces, nosotros recién pusimos Jill has gone on vacation. Si está muy para allá, lo puedo mover después, ¿ya? Lo puedo mover un poquito para acá. Aquí un poquito para acá. ¿Ven? Luego que haga todas las modificaciones. Lo guardo y una persona del grupo lo va a subir a Google Classroom con el nombre de los compañeros en algún lado. Lo puede escribir arriba del documento, no sé. Aquí pueden escribir, incluso pueden mover cosas del mismo documento, ¿ya? Es demasiado bueno este programa. Clear. ¿Estamos claros?
Yes, profe.
Okay, so I'm gonna ask the names of the people from the groups. Porque vamos a hacer el grupo ahora. Okay, groups. Ah, ya. Yeah. Voy a explicar eso hasta que terminemos la clase, ¿ya? Thank you, Sofía.
Profe, las tareas... Otra pregunta. Las tareas que envió, ¿tienen fechas para entregarla, no?
La que tiene la de ahora, la que tienen que hacer ahora con sus compañeros para la próxima semana. Tienen que quedar lista antes de la próxima clase.
Okay.
Ya, y aquí publiqué lo siguiente. Esto es the irregular verbs wrap challenge. Okay, I'm going to explain this. Resulta que yo les comenté que los verbos regulares es muy difícil aprenderlos con esta tabla, así como sentarse y poner cut 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 tic tac tac, es muy difícil, ¿ya? Es muy latero y no funciona. Entonces, Mr. D, como le gusta la música, la mejor forma es la siguiente. Yo aquí les dejé el rap de los verbos irregulares. Hay un profesor que hizo un rap y pone todos los verbos irregulares, o la gran mayoría. Aquí les puse el material, ¿ya? Donde la idea es que ustedes completen el material, escuchando la canción, con lo mismo, con el PDF y todo. Se aprendan el rap. Tienen el mes completo, ¿ya? Se aprenden el rap, lo practican y lo graban con su celular. Se graban ustedes con la música de fondo. Diciendo el rap, bla, 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 bla. Y lo suben a Google Classroom en esta tarea. Si usted completa el desafío, yo le doy 3 décimas que las puede ocupar en cualquier prueba. Si quiere puede ocupar dos en una y una en la otra, o tres en una prueba que venga, como sea. Pero esto es un challenge especial para las personas que desean ya aprenderse los verbos y no nunca más estar dando bote. Es con los verbos dichos. Está todo acá. Tienes que escucharlo. Sofía, ¿ya? Aquí está, te puse. Aquí está la canción con los verbos. Aquí está la guía donde está la misma canción. Tú completas con lo que escuchas. Y aquí está el karaoke. Entonces, al momento que tú tengas que mandar el challenge, pones el karaoke de fondo y tú vas como rapeando los verbos encima. Es re fácil. Ya, yo creo que es fácil y práctico. Si no quieres sufrir después con todo lo que viene de los verbos, mi recomendación, haz el challenge. Es muy importante. Ya, eso es el tema del challenge. Vamos al tema de los grupos. Ok, groups. Ah, ahí estaba mostrando otra cosa, lo siento. Aquí estaba el tema del challenge. Aquí está aquí está la canción. Aquí está la letra de la canción, para que la completes. Después te la estudias mucho, después te grabas y pones este aquí, es como la pista de fondo. Y te grabas con el celular y me mandas la pista de audio. Obviamente yo nomás la puedo escuchar, así que no hay nada de temor ni cosas así. Si lo logras, 3 décimas. Esto tienen todo el mes para hacerlo, ya, entonces quedan como 15 días más. Ya, yeah. Ok, groups. Quiero que empiecen a trabajar el otro. Let's go to the groups. Okay, give me the names, please. People, let's start the groups. People, hello. Oh my God.
What? ¿Qué cosa?
Vamos a empezar a trabajar la actividad de grupo.
Ah, ya. Yeah.
La que le dejé acá, esta que está aquí, de la página 112. Así que necesito que me den el nombre de las personas de los grupos. 3 maximum. 3 people maximum. 3 people max. Thank you. 3 people max. Y aquí llegó uno. Emilia Vergara, Sofía Morcilla. Thank you. Sofía Morcilla. Thank you. Ok. Ya, pero intenta que se meta. Oye, se salieron harto. Ojo, ahora son 28. Ok, Camilo, no worries. Ok, Coral. Work alone. Ok. What about the others? Anyone else, please? Nope. Okay, I think we don't have the time to do this because you guys are gonna, it's 5 more minutes. So please work this during the week, finish it before the next class. And if you have any questions, you can post here questions. So do you have any questions about the homework or the challenge, people, before we finish the class?
No.
Thank you, Lucas, for your honesty. Sí, que ponga los nombres de los grupos en el mismo documento, ¿ya? Póngalo, no sé, pues acá, mira. Con el texto y aquí poner, no sé, Sofía, bueno, Sofía Hermosilla, Miss Emilia, por ejemplo, ok, like that, y se graba solo, ¿ya? Aquí después subirlo. So please do that in the program, in the software that I send you, ok, be clever, and I will see you again next class, ok, people.
All right.
Okay. Hey, if you have any questions, please use the Google Classroom. Bye-bye. Take care. Have a good Thursday.